It should be good. Got music. I think I want to listen to it. So, I'm 1 week into my job, new job, working as a baker. It's a weird choice, I know, but I did it because it was weird, and it's a part-time job that's really close to me. So I wanted to give it a shot. After a week of it, it's not that bad. There's a lot of standing around, I think is the worst part of it, but it's not that bad. It's not like I'm on my feet the entire day. I can take breaks and sit down every now and then. So, it's not the worst. It's pretty easy. It's just a lot of stuff to remember. A lot of different types of breads that I did not know existed. But, yeah, I don't know. I'm starting to get settled into it. Which I like. I think that took all the pressure off. At least that's how it feels, because now this isn't a job or a thing that I feel like I'm failing at. This is just the other thing. So let's get back to work. I do. Like, it's a part-time job, but it is 6 hours a day, which is still, I don't know, it's still like the majority of the day, it feels like, or the majority that I'm awake. Maybe it just feels that way. Probably does. It's 6.5 hours because of an unpaid lunch. But, so I haven't felt like drawling. I felt like it as in I wanted to, but just been, I'd rather like spend my day not drawing, at least for the first couple days. Now I think I want to get into like the momentum of I go to work and then at night I do this, and then the morning between getting ready for work, you know, I wake up early, so that'll be my me time. If I can get into that kind of rhythm, that would be great. And then I got 2 days off, so that can be me time as well. So yeah, if I could just get it into a habit to do like 2 or 3 hours every night, I think I'd be doing a lot better than I was before. Anyway, we're going to animate this guy. I love what he looks like, coming back to look at him again. Maybe I gave him too much gizzard. Too many chins. I kind of like the idea of it, but maybe it would look better if he was more streamlined. I mean, it is a kind of a thing with aquatic animals. Nah, I mean, a lot of times they are streamlined too. I wonder if I should get rid of that or not. It would add to some secondary motion, which could be good. Like, as his head turns, the little thing flops behind. But he's got tentacles, so that's already got a lot of extra motion. Let's try it and see what I think of it. I'm just going to duplicate it. We got the old one. Thank you. don't know. I kind of like the fun bags. You just make it more off-putting. More alien creepy. Also, it's I like the weird contrast between something dangerous, but also having fat rolls. Or, it's not really, I don't know, it's just extra skin. Yeah, it worked for amnesia. I'm gonna keep it. I think it looks better this way. Alright, so what do we gotta draw? We gotta draw some rotations. I wonder if I should go ahead and just throw this into an animation frame so that I can see the onion skinning. That way I can do it piece by piece instead of trying to do the whole picture. Need to squish the body. Let's do it like this. I'm gonna cheat in some ways. I'm gonna squish the tail without squishing the front part of the body. not sure I'm going to do this. I want to have the body take up like the majority and then the tail just trailing. So it goes from where it is to this one. The next one, his head will be facing the other way. It'll be mostly like the majority of the mass of the body will be pointing towards us. And the head will be facing the other way because he's turning that way. I think I need to redraw everything up here, actually. Probably would look best. We'll just keep the back. I want this on another page. This is, it's a lot of lines to sort there. Right now, I just build the body around that. All right, one more should get it there. Which is just, shouldn't be too hard. Alright, I think that should be enough for a turn. Just three frames. It should happen really quick. So, you won't really even notice as long as it's the main action of it turning. Then it goes to full turn. I think that'll be fine. Right, so what else is there? We did the turn. Next is swimming animation. I forget all the stuff I made marks here. I know this one's for charging. Oh, that one was for swimming, yeah. Forgot to close its jaw before I did all that. It's fine, it can have its mouth open when it turns. Heck, I can even have it have its mouth open most of the time. Maybe except for the swim. I don't know. We'll have it open its mouth when it turns, it doesn't matter. But I should close it right now. It means I want to make a duplicate for when it's open. Do I even want to have it close its mouth? I guess so. Yeah, it's fine. All right. Swimming animation. I have no idea how I'm gonna do this. I think first thing, I'm gonna look at Wells again. Actually, I don't think I need to. Just thinking how they move the front flippers. But I think they just move them up and down. Maybe very subtly. And seeing as that's kind of hard to do, I might just move it back and forth a little bit, kind of like a doggy paddle. Very slight though. Most of its movement's coming from the tail. I think that's what I'll do. So, what do I want to do here? Let's... make this folder. I mean, at minimum, it's going to be 4 frames, but I might need more than that. Let's do 4 to start with. I think I want 8 though. I want it to go 1, 2, 3. Alright, so let's just start here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I need 8 frames. I think it will be 8 frames. Because I want a nice slow movement of the tail instead of like the other ones. I mean, it's the final boss. It should look more complicated. There are some repeated frames here. I could probably get away with just stretching this. Doing some transformation. Probably should have drawn it. Okay, I know what I'm gonna do. I'll delete this one. Duplicate that one. And we'll draw this one. the basic tail swim. I think I should have cut this into pieces. Just because there's a lot of things moving. Well, really it's just three different movements. I think I will do that. It'll just make it easier to copy stuff later. I guess here I can do those front fins because it's the easiest. All right, I'm just focused on that part. Honestly, what I should do is put a dot so that I can be consistent. What I'm going to do, actually, I like this idea. I'll have the front one move and then the back one move. So it's very lazy as far as front movement. Is that good or is that too mechanical? Seems pretty mechanical and cheap. I think with the additional, the last one, it'll look better. All right, this is the hard one. Let's do this first. It's a tentacle movement. That was really bad. Step one, always start on the top frame. Let's come back to normal on that one. So if that one's normal, okay, then this one's normal here. This one's normal here. Okay, now they're gonna be off kilter.
Thank you.
Yeah, I got a drink.
Thank you.
These two change too swiftly.
Thank you.
That looks pretty busy. Just need to erase all that. Well, we're gonna get the two hardest animations done with at least. Swimming. Chart shouldn't be too hard. Pretty simple. I think it's the final one. Will be more challenging. Anyway, I'm gonna take a break. Be right back. Okay. Quit looking me. Goofy. I did it again. Thank you. If there's anything I'm not happy with, it's the front hat, the front paws, the fins. Ooh, the front fins. My voice has been very out of it. I mean, more than usual. I wonder if it would have been better if they just don't move. Let's try that. It's not too hard to just test real quick. I think I like it better with them not moving at all. That looks too weird. That or I have to animate it a different way. So I'm not really wanting to bother with. I think we'll just have it not move. I like that so much I'm about to delete this. Bam. Alright. Okay, that's swimming. I have to combine all that together, but there's no reason to. I'll just do the line work over top of it. So, there's that. There's turning. And then I just reverse this for the other direction. It's mouth open. That little bit that I need. Over here. Alright, so next up will probably be the charge up. Alright, so I had swimming, I had rotating, charge up. Look at my notepad. Swim, charge up, charge, transition. Gotta draw the projectile. Yeah, I gotta do the overworld stuff too. And boss fight animation is just gonna be this cling to the rock and produce electricity or something. So, do I need a spit animation though? I mean, the spit animation would just be an open the mouth. Still not entirely sold on the spitting part. For the projectile. I could give it like some sort of on body cannon kind of thing. Bulbasaur? Not Bulbasaur. Blastoise. Give him some sort of Blastoise kind of like opening that projectiles come out of. It seems weird to shoot like poison or acid when he uses electricity in the end. I think it definitely has to be electricity for the whole the way the final boss works. I wanted to shoot some sort of electrical thing, I think. I'll just do like an animation of like whatever glowy stuff I'm gonna put on this guy. To where it like builds up into the head where those little bones are, the vertebrae, and then it just discharges. I think it'll do like that. That way I don't have to animate anything. Do I want to like do an animation for opening the mouth then? That's the real question. I could do like one frame to open the mouth. I might end up doing that. I'll do that when I do line work. Even though he's not going to spit, I do want him to open his mouth when he shoots. Stop doing that. Don't tap on the pen. Pen's expensive. Yeah, okay. I think I will do one animation for opening the mouth. So instead of it being, it'll still be like the foggy effect, but it'll be like an electricity cloud or something. I don't know, I'll figure it out. It's comet or meteor magic. Kind of away from science. I mean, I think this, as soon as you have lightning underwater, you're already breaking the rules. I don't even think lightning can be underwater. It can, of course, flow underwater, but I don't think you can see it underwater. Because there's no air being ionized, but maybe, I don't know. This is an interesting question. I don't know, there's a lot of like fantasy stuff, but I don't know if it's actually true or not. Maybe it can go underwater. All right, I guess charge up would be the next big one. So to charge, it's pretty easy.
Let's see here.
Do I even do this now?
This is done.
To charge up, I just want to move things to be in a aggressive position.
I'm a balls player. I'm the reason that you lost.
Dr. Wily and Robotnik, we're the scientific losses. Wanna play, we got the way to turn wins to losses. Turn truth to falses.
My IQ is sweet.
We've been working on some robots that just cannot be beat.
I'm a hedgehog buster.
Evil masterminder. Our mustaches will kill you. Better look out right behind you.
Cause you're gonna have to prove your problem is bigger than brain.
Take our robotic inventions for providing you pain.
I'm Magneto, I'm a doctor too. And right now it ain't just metal I'm attracted to.
Oh hi, how you do? I don't mean to intrude, but I just ain't for dudes. And I'm still looking to booze. I'm half human, half dragon, four rods and three.
Alright, so that's what we have to transition into. Makes it easy, I just move things around until they reach there. Probably over two frames. Really should have copied some stuff in here. I mean, it won't matter as long as I do it. I just really need to do the parts that animate. But if I had something to copy, it would be even better. At least for the fins. This count as the mouth opening and closing. No, I really need to stop now. I have a bad time. Can't really keep going. This one's almost done. It's not too hard. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna try and do this daily. I'm not promising anything because I might be wore out. And I hate making promises on stream to myself. Anyway, I do want to do this more often. That is true. So, hopefully I can keep at this and do this like 2 or 3 hours every night. 5 days a week, that would be sweet. That's the plan. Who knows if it'll work out. All right, that's it for me. Later.